Say AGM Radio.
Radio.
AGM Radio.
I love radio.
Daddy. You'll get it one day.
Welcome to the Greater Day Cafe with Dr. Davina, a nighttime cafe of inspirational thoughts to unwind from negativity and reaffirm our goodness. Now here's your host, Dr. Davina.
What's up, everybody? Happy Thursday. Happy Thursday to everybody that's listening, and happy Greater Day. So you're tuned in, and we thank you so much. We got some repeat tune in, so we thank you so much for tuning in for our 30 minutes of fun, inspiration, and insight right here at the Greater Day Cafe on the AGM Network. So we're glad you're here. Make sure you're helping your friends stay connected with us. So listen, we know that some of you had a little difficulty last week, but don't worry about it. We got the show recorded for you. We got it up on YouTube. So if you're going to DavinaJones.com, you can see some of our selected past shows. Got a few past shows sitting there waiting for you to listen to. So that way you don't miss out on all the good fun. Now, we're not promising you that every show is going to be there, because we need the numbers to be on Thursday nights at 8:30. However, we do have a few selected specials there waiting for you. So make sure you tune in. And anything you need, you go to DavinaJones.com. And make sure everybody knows how to, you know, want to comment on Twitter, Facebook, and all that good stuff. We're running some promos now. We've been giving away some cash. Somebody say cash.
Cash. Ah!
So we've been giving away some cash. So if you want to get some cash, you got to go to the website. Make sure you know how to stay connected with us and win some of that money. But I will tell you, winning the money is really all about being connected with us. So go to www.davinajones.com, and from there you can link up to the Facebook, and you share, you comment, you like the page, and also submit a question. So we got a few people that have been submitting questions, and so I have really enjoyed addressing questions as individuals, as the listeners submit. And I tell you, I love that, because it means that I'm able to focus on what the listeners want to focus on. So this show is about you. It's about allowing me to inspire you from where you are. And so a really good way to do that is when you submit questions. So we're going to put up a question from Facebook as soon as that time comes in a little bit. But right now, we're going to get ready to roll you into my co-host moment. So my co-host is sitting here with me. Co-host, say hey to the people.
Hey, people, 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 people.
And what's your name? I just like to hear you say it.
Rochester J.
I don't know why I like to hear you say your name, but you say it with such confidence, and you got a little swagger in there, too.
Well, I
love it.
Thank you
so
very
happy
much.
Thursday, Rochester.
Happy Thursday, Dr.
Happy
D.
Greater Day.
Happy Greater Day to
happy
you.
Happy Greater Season.
Happy Greater Season.
And all of that.
And all of that.
And then y'all know we got our team members here. So Wade, Patrick, they can't see you, but Patrick is our in-house AGM engineer. He's back here working the tables for us. My sister, my sidekick, Lady G, is sitting up here. And so she's helping to keep the show rolling, directing, and so forth. And then y'all know we're starting to train them. So I got my little niece here. She's our social media director. Danae, say hey to the people. She said, hi. She's trying to act all shy. I'm going to tell y'all right now, that sister is not shy. Don't let her fool you. That's why she up in the radio station with her auntie. So we're going to make sure they get trained. All right. So listen, we're getting ready to go into the first segment. So those of you that have been listening, you know what this first segment is all about. But just before I do that, I got to go back and tell you once again, if you have missed the past shows, and if you have missed these segments, you got to go to DavinaJones.com so you can get those YouTube links. Because I'll tell you what, my co-host been setting it off up in here with his something good testimonies. I'm telling you what. You know, a couple of times
thank
I just
you.
Skipped all over my little cafe moment and just rocked it out with his something good segment. So y'all make sure y'all go and check that out. So, Patrick, I want you to give us our hint so we can bring my co-host in for his segment. On the count of 3, 1, 2, hit me!
Oh! Yeah!
Uh-oh! It's coming! It's coming!
It's
I think
it's
coming.
It's coming.
If
it's
not...
Stuck. The CDO's stuck.
The CD... You about to make me cough. I don't know whether to cough or laugh. So it got a little stuck, but that's all right. We'll make sure we'll give you a little taste of our music coming up. So anyways. My co-host has been rocking it out with this segment that we call Something Good.
Something Good.
And so, you know what I've never told you?
What's that?
I've never told you how I came up with this segment.
I would really like to know.
Okay, so here's the deal. I had a boyfriend in the past.
Yes.
And one of our boyfriends, every time we would talk on the phone, he would always say, tell me something good.
Really?
And you know, it was the strangest thing, because every time he said, tell me something good, I would get stuck like, it was just ridiculous. But you know, even though we're no longer dating, I mean, he's a great guy. Sure. Hello to you in the world, wherever you are. But you know, out of that relationship, that nice little positive nugget just really stayed with me.
You can't give us a first name.
No, I won't do that. I mean, it ain't nothing bad, but you know, you don't want to be interrupting people's household either. I mean, you know, hey, everybody done moved on. Keep moving. You know, let them move on up. Don't move down. Move up. I'll support your well-being wherever you are. So anyways, that was the inspiration for the something good. So I figured, you know what? I like that. So I'm going to work it into the show. So anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I want to bring out with you right now my co-host. And so we're going to drop the hint. We done told you the hint, but I just like to hear it from Chaka Khan. Can we go? Can
Chaka
we go? Can we do it? Can we do it? Can we do it? We can't do it. We can do it. Technology is something else. It's a booger.
It's
every now and then.
It's now and then.
He said it's now and then. It's all right. So, Rochester.
Yes.
I have really enjoyed your something good. So, tell me something good.
Well, again, I appreciate you allowing me to be here with you, Dr.
So kind.
D, and this awesome, awesome movement that is happening all over the land. Greater Day Cafe. My something good today is happiness versus joy.
Mm.
Now, I know a lot of people talk about that a lot, you know.
Okay.
You know, it's a great movie that came out back in 2006.
Okay.
In the Pursuit of Happiness.
Yes, yes.
The story that outlined, if you will, Chris Gardner's life, played out by Will Smith and his son. Very, very great movie. If you have not seen that, I recommend you stop by the Red Box, Blockbuster, if they still open, or somebody, and get that movie.
Why are you trying to throw shade on Blockbuster?
But I'm just saying, no. A Hulu, YouTube, I mean, hey.
Right.
But anyway, I thought that, you know, being in the pursuit of happiness would be the best option for life. But then I found out joy is also an option as well. So, you know, in pursuit of happiness, I figured this. Happiness, and we hear this cliche a lot, you know, happiness is based on happenings.
Okay, yes.
So why would I choose happiness versus joy? So I had to turn the vehicle of my life in another direction and start journeying towards Joy Lane versus Happiness Boulevard.
I like it. Yes, go
because
ahead
listen,
on this
point. Okay, so here's why. So many people are using that cliche, especially those that are in pursuit of relationships goals, life goals, marriage goals. You know, a lot of them say, I just want to be happy.
Right, right.
But then there you go. You get what you ask for. You put out in the universe. Because you just
want to be happy. And that's all you get.
And that's all you're going to get. Because guess what? That feeling is based on happenings.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But you're not prepared for the other side of that joyous type experience that come with that word happiness, right? So you just want to be happy. But here's the thing. The most common disbelief that happiness is something that could be achieved and held on to is that. You can't hold on to happiness. It's almost like trying to put a whole lot of sand in the palm of your hand and hoping it stay there.
Okay.
Not realizing that through the palm of your hand are cracks.
Slipping.
Come on here now. You have slips and cracks between your fingers, and before you know it, all that sand you had in your hand done poured out, right?
Slippery happiness.
So think about this. Marriage, right?
Yes.
We a lot of people think that, you know, when I get married, I'm gonna be happy,
right?
Be real, real happy.
And we talked about last week,
we did, right?
Yeah, keep going.
Then they go through the honeymoon, right? Happy, right? Soon as you get done with the marriage ceremony and the honeymoon, you come back home. Are you still happy?
Right? Might be broke.
Wait. See, I was just about to say something, because guess what? All of that wave of excitement, eventually has to come back down the other side of the mountain because you got bills, like you said, when you get back home. You got the AC that want to act up on you.
Right.
You got all these things. Car want to act funny.
Yes.
But you was happy a month ago, 2 weeks ago when we got married.
Yes,
right?
Correct. Okay.
How about this? When you graduate.
Uh-huh.
Graduate high school.
Right.
Happy.
Happy.
All right.
And then you can't get no job.
Wait a minute. Still happy because you got some people go on to college happy.
Okay, yes. All right. Yes.
Finish college.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Still happy because you just riding this wave. I done finished high school. I done went on here to further my education a little bit. Got this college thing behind me. Guess what? Mm-hmm. Now it's time to go online and look for a job. Happy still?
Right.
Oh, no.
So how do we get to this joy thing?
So here's what I say. The goal of being happy is always going to remain elusive because happiness that's supposed to last is never found, right?
Mm.
So my thing is, it's better to seek out joy.
Wow. Okay.
Now, joy is related to happiness.
Okay.
But here's the difference between joy. Mm-hmm. Happiness focuses on the me, the I.
Okay.
You know, it's a selfish feeling. It's what you want to feel.
Okay.
It's what you want to experience.
Mm-hmm.
However, joy is what's going to take you deeper into that moment because joy is what's going to sustain you.
Mm. And joy is not dependent upon what's happening.
Exactly. Because joy is so greater.
Uh-huh.
It allows you to experience other people for who they are. Why? Because you're not moved on who they are. You're not moved
what
by
they're doing.
What they're doing.
Yes.
You're not moved by the situation.
Yes.
Why? Because you have centered yourself with the fact that you're going to have peace.
Yes.
And you're going to have joy. No matter what
we just
happens.
High five. Y'all couldn't see that, but we just high five each other. Okay, can I give a testimony?
Please, by all means.
Okay, so I want to give a little something with that. I relate to that because okay, I'm gonna make this short because I know 8:45 we gonna move into a commercial thing and then come back for the cafe. Okay, but see, so several years ago,
all right,
I had my two godchildren in the back seat of the car with me, and we went to Checkers.
Mm-hmm.
And so, give me Checkers a free plug, Lord have mercy. We went to
Checker
a restaurant.
Fries off the chain,
we Rally's, went to fast Checkers. Food restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyways, we went to Checkers, mm-hmm. and we ordered our food. But after they gave us the food,
right.
and after I paid for the food, the lady then told me they didn't have any ketchup.
Mercy.
Now you know what? Let me tell y'all right now. I'm just gonna be transparent. I clicked on this lady.
No.
Yes, I did.
All behind the ketchup.
I clicked on her right now. But here's the thing. Mm-hmm. It really wasn't about the ketchup. Before I even ordered that food, I had already decided that the world was against me, that somebody's against me, and that I was just looking for an opportunity to click. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I was walking around with all that negative energy, and I had already decided before there was no ketchup that I was upset.
Right.
So that just became a reason to demonstrate my upsetness. Mm-hmm. But then fast forward, I was in another fast food restaurant. This time I was in McDonald's.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I am getting healthier, everybody. But anyways, I was in McDonald's this time, and there was a lady that came in, and you know how sometimes there's a line, but it's not a straight line,
right.
So you don't really know who's next.
Mm-hmm.
So the lady, she did ask, she said, she asked this other guy, are you in line?
Mm-hmm.
And he said no.
Right.
Well, I was next, but I didn't say I'm next, and nobody else said, well, she's next.
Right.
So the lady went up in order. When she fit now, I didn't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't say a thing.
Right.
It didn't alarm me or anything. You know why? Because unlike when I went to Checkers on this day, I decided before that happened that I was already at peace.
That's
already centered. So when she went before me, I didn't say anything.
Yeah.
And so after she ordered, I ordered. Mm-hmm. And then she came back and she said, ma'am, I'm so sorry. I said, it's okay.
Wow.
Worse things have happened than that.
Yeah.
I just waited until you were done. It's okay. It's no big deal.
Right.
But how do you have those moments? That's a moment of joy. But that joy, I had already determined that joy before that happening.
Yeah.
Versus the other situation, I had already determined angry before it happened. So there's something to be said about what you said, centering yourself in a moment of deciding that I am okay.
Right.
And I am at peace.
Mm-hmm.
It's a greater day.
It is a greater day.
Whether you skip me in line or not.
Right.
Whether you have ketchup or not.
Right. And you know, joy is a greater feeling to experience than happiness.
Yes. Right? That's right. Yeah.
It is a much greater because here's why.
Mm-hmm.
When happiness crosses suffering, it is joy that's going to sustain you through it all.
It's going to take you on over. So y'all need to get some joy so
it's
y'all don't click on nobody
don't
about
be clicking.
That ketchup.
Don't be clicking about no ketchup.
We don't want y'all clicking on people, end up in
the
newspaper.
But them Checkers fries will make you click, though, because them things be good. Get out of my
tell me now. show you right. All right, folks, listen, that's a little something good. Yeah, y'all need to take that. Stop depending on what's happening in order to be happy.
And expect joy.
And expect
Seek
joy.
Seek the joy.
And go ahead and just decide to be.
Be joy.
Just be joy.
Be joyful.
Be what you want. Yeah. You want joy? Be it. Ladies and gentlemen, we got to go to a quick break. This break is going to go for about a minute and 30 seconds. So I'm going to tell you what you need to do. Go get you a quick snack.
Snack.
What's the snack? Three carrots. And how many cookies?
Two.
Don't overdo it. We'll see you right back here in just a few at the Greater Day Cafe right here on the AGM Radio Network. Yeah.
Stay tuned for more Greater Day Cafe right here on the AGM Radio Network.
$23 million small businesses are open for business in the United States, providing more than half of all American jobs. What helps these small businesses thrive? A location where people need its services. The availability of good transportation, a well-trained labor force, and a healthy infrastructure. An attractive streetscape and comfort and safety for pedestrians. Good planning connects small businesses to the customers they need, fostering the competition that helps healthy businesses grow. Whether you own a small business, work at a small business, or bought from a small business, and that's just about all of us, make the connection. Learn more at planning.org. That's planning.org. A message from this station and the American Planning Association.
Hey now, this is Cedric the Entertainer. Nearly 5 million African Americans have diabetes, which may cause burning, shooting pain known as painful diabetic peripheral neuropathy or diabetic nerve pain. My dad has diabetic nerve pain. I knew something was wrong when I saw him finding ways to work around the pain. Step on up. Don't suffer in silence. Have a real conversation with your doctor about your burning, shooting pain in your feet or hands and take a step towards some pain relief. Visit steponup.com to learn more.
Welcome back to the Greater Day Cafe right here on the AGM Radio Network. Now here's your host, Dr. D.
All right, welcome back to the Greater Day Cafe. That was a little bit of my girl, Jill Scott. Now, let me tell you, when I hear that song, Golden, I almost go into my meditation language.
Yes.
It's what the old people call speaking in tongues. Why? Because let me tell you, that is one of my anthems right there, living my life like it's golden. Oh, so y'all don't get too bored if y'all hear that almost every week, if not every other week. That's just my little theme, right? That's my own little personal anthem. And it really kind of helps support what we're trying to do with our 30 minutes fun, inspirational insight to help you live a greater day, help you
Absolutely.
Get a little golden going on, living my life like it's golden. And I love when she says, living my life like it's golden. Oh, I love that part. All right, so anyways, welcome back. Glad you tuned in. So we got a few minutes left. I know the NBA finals are coming up. So now thank y'all for joining in. I'm so glad y'all tuned in and didn't get too distracted so that you didn't come and get your inspirational fix before the game. Depending on who you're rooting for, depending on who's gonna win, you might need this little inspiration. You might need that joy to carry you on through.
Unspeakable.
Depending on who wins or who loses. So listen, what we've been doing every week is we've been inviting you
right.
to submit questions. That way, and I have to tell you, I have been enjoying excuse me, literally enjoying. I teach y'all full time, so my voice is a little tired. But I have absolutely been enjoying getting the questions from audience members so that we could actually direct, you know, the content according to the listeners. So I'm really, really enjoying it, because sometimes what's on my mind, it might be absolutely boring to y'all, okay? Because I'm going to tell you, I'm an NPR junkie, first of all. So sorry about that. I love AGM, but I got a little diverse little potluck going on. So I do AGM. I got AGM going on in my office, and then I get me a little news fix for NPR. So I got a lot of stuff running around in my head. But anyways, so it's really good to get y'all's questions so that then I can base some of our content pieces off of really where you are. So, all right. So we got a question. Here's the question that one of my sister friends submitted. So, Rosella, if you are listening,
Rosella,
you have selected the question, or your question, I shall say, has been selected for tonight. So, this is her question. Now, if you've heard the past two questions, you're probably thinking that only singles listen to the show. Mm-hmm. But it's just only singles that gave me the past 3 weeks of questions. So, sure. I got to take what they give me, okay?
Right.
So, if y'all married people, y'all want me to talk about something else, then y'all got to send me a question.
Step it up.
So here was the question. The question is, when is it a good time? When is it the right time to introduce your child or your children to someone that you're dating, that you're seeing? And I'm just loving these questions. First of all, like I told you, I don't think there's one right answer to any of these questions. Mm-hmm. I think there are different ways that you have to look at some of these questions that we've been entertaining. So I don't think there's one right answer, but I'd like to take a few minutes to help you make sure you experience a greater day in the midst of all of your life questions and so forth. So with this question, which although it comes from a single person, just because I know her. But this is a question, you know, singleness is not defined by just as being a stereotypical, maybe 25-year-old. Mm-hmm. But we have a number of individuals that have been married and, you know, divorced, mm-hmm. and now single, newly single.
Right.
And so some of these are kind of new issues.
Okay.
And so when is it the right time? First of all, I don't think there's one big right answer for that. But I think there are some more important questions to ask ourselves about these dating relationships and when we have children. Mm-hmm. So that, one question I think you should probably ask yourself is, you know, are you really in a relationship, or are you comfortable in this relationship? Does this relationship involve a lot of positive energy and goodwill, or is this relationship really built around what you might call a booty call? The reason why I say that.
Why must I be like that?
So if you got somebody that's only chasing the cat, mm-hmm. then yes, you should be concerned with bringing your kids into that atmosphere. But see, this is something that I really thought about when I saw the question. Why aren't we modeling for our kids what we want them to do? So do you not want to be involved in your children's introductions to who they're seeing, who they're dating? Mm. So if you want, in other words, do you want to teach your children how to date?
Right.
Because if you want to teach them how to date, which I think that's really important. I think that previous generations did not model, and we did not teach our next generation how to entertain company,
right.
How to take company, how to court. And so when you sneak and hide and do everything, guess what you're teaching your kids to do?
Sneaky.
You teaching your kids to sneak and hide and do everything. Mm-hmm. And so I think there are different ways that you can do this, but certainly I think that if you have a comfortable, goodwill relationship, mm-hmm. then it doesn't hurt to have some group outings, some family outings, right. and so forth that might involve someone that you have a relationship with, you know. Now I know we can't answer all the details in between, you know, with these few minutes, mm-hmm. but really what I really want to put forth is, what do you want to model with your children? So if they never see, like, for example, I have a friend who says they never saw their parents argue. They never saw their parents argue. Now, what's the problem with that?
Well, the problem with that is you don't teach your kids mm-hmm. how to debate.
There you go. That's my point.
In the confines of family.
That's it.
But then on the other spectrum, on the other side of that spectrum,
mm-hmm.
you do teach a bad model if you are constantly
sure.
arguing.
Absolutely.
Week after week, month after. If you arguing more weeks than there are... in a month.
Right.
Yeah.
Point taken. Absolutely. But to have a healthy, right. you know, conversation about what I disagree with, you know, well, babe, I think really we should do mm-hmm. it this way. Well, honey, I don't think that. Blah, blah, blah. If your kids never witness you having some kind of a healthy debate, mm-hmm. a healthy argument, or how do you healthy. Solve problems? Yeah, healthy. I know that's the whole thing. We got to go back to last week with healthy because they're going to have to get counseling. That's what you talked about.
Your some of these good, arguments, right? things go to flying across the house
right.
that we're not meant to fly. Like the ceiling right. fan is the only thing that should be exactly. flying in the house.
Right, exactly, exactly, right. There are a lot of precursors to what I'm saying.
Jeez.
A lot of precursors.
Words flying, right. objects flying.
Absolutely. So a lot of precursors to what I'm saying. So, you know, if you really are pursuing a healthy relationship, then parts of that relationship should be revealed to your children as a role model so that they can know how to take company.
I think you made a good point in the amount of time that we have because we could really dig into this and we might have
right.
to have a part two of this mm-hmm. next week. Just,
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
something to think about.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think of it like this. If you planned an outing with that friend without mm-hmm. necessarily telling the kids all the business that this is somebody necessarily that you send,
mm-hmm.
they don't know if it's a coworker. They wouldn't know if it was somebody that you are networking
mm-hmm.
with. They didn't gotta know all of that.
Mm-mm.
But the healthy thing about it is they are out with you with that person to see how that environment, how the kids
right.
acclimate to, you know, yep, your friend.
Absolutely.
You know, so there's so many nuances.
There are.
You
there are a lot of nuances.
You can't cover
yeah.
this in
know,
the amount of time.
I know,
we
got
to have a part
know,
two because this is heavy. This is very good.
Rochester is voting for a part two.
This
got to
be
this.
Continued on next week because
but
we
you're right.
really,
there are a lot of nuances to this.
Yeah.
So, for example, I know that this one author said that she chose to not bring anyone around her children until her children were teenagers. So there are a number
I want to say
ways.
Why.
Well, you know, because she felt like she needed to protect that part of their life where she was still nurturing
mm-hmm.
and that when they become a teenager.
So is that the kid's fault or is that her?
I don't think it's anybody's fault.
Well, I
won't
say fault. I was, right. Well, I did, but.
right.
But what I would say is, why would you hold back from their experience and you're experiencing
yeah.
and they're part of you?
Fair question. And that
is
and that's
it because
why
you're not healed?
Right. Well, and that's why I'm saying it's a fair question. And
baggage.
To your point, a lot of nuances.
A lot of nuances
to this.
So
that's why I say I don't think there's one right answer. But what I really want to pose out there is if you really are pursuing and building healthy relationships, then consider what part of the relationship mm-hmm. you would like to reveal to right. your children as a role model mm-hmm. so that they'll know how men and women perhaps should greet each
and
other.
Here's the thing.
You know?
I think this.
Mm-hmm.
The kids will model their behavior after your behavior. If you happy,
that's my point.
The kid's going to be
that's
happy.
My point.
I was talking to a friend of mine today
mm-hmm.
and she told me about a friend of hers that has two children
mm-hmm.
and met a man who has two children.
Mm-hmm.
But because the mom is happy,
mm-hmm.
the kids are happy to meet the man's children.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just an awesome combination
sure.
of two families
sure.
coming together
sure.
in a dating relationship and potentially a marriage.
Sure.
So that was just a little
so
short.
So now listen, we're
testimony.
Not telling everybody to go out there and expose your kids
now.
To everything.
Hold up now.
I'm just saying consider the
meditate on it.
meditate on really how much goodwill and positive energy do you have floating in your exchange.
Right.
Now I'll say this, if you know that ain't nothing but a booty call, then don't bring them around your kids, okay? But now if you know you're in a healthy relationship.
Why must I be like that?
I know, I'm sorry. I just putting it out there. Your kids don't need to meet 15 uncles and wonder why they only
yeah.
saw them uncles for 2 months at a
call
time.
Call them uncles now.
You know, I'm just
oh,
saying.
Boy.
All right, so we might have to do a part two on
Mercy.
This one. In the meantime, consider and meditate. Listen, we're about 2 minutes, 1 minute and 30 seconds on our way out the door. I want to tell you, stay connected to us at DavinaJones.com.
Do it.
You got to go there because, listen, we got a lot of things coming up. I'm going to be talking about, when we come back next week, I'm going to be talking about our speech camp. I'm going to be hosting a public speaking camp for middle school students. So the information is already at the website. So I'm not going to talk about it now. I'll get to it another time. But go to the website and start looking at that because you need to get your kids in the camp. Our kids need to know how to communicate. It's a shame.
It's a shame.
The children don't know how to communicate, okay? So y'all getting ready to sign up. Also, when you go there, you're going to see that every first Monday night, I hold spiritual teaching, spiritual gathering. So you can read about that there. In the meantime, we got to sign out. I hope you enjoy a little 30 minutes of fun, inspiration, and insight. Hello to everybody, all of our team members here at AGM Rochester. You know I love you, baby.
Love you back.
So glad you're with me now, all right? All right, we got to sign out. We'll see you next time right here at Greater Day Cafe.
Hey.
Press right
like
here on
share,
the AGM Radio
comment
Network.
And thank you.
Yes, like us. Bye. We like you.